General Dynamics X-62 VISTA is the latest update to one of the most unique experimental aircraft models in the world, with groundbreaking pieces of technology that make it capable of performing stunts no other aircraft of its kind can achieve. Derived from the F-16 Fighting Falcon, its VISTA acronym comes from Variable Stability In-Flight Simulator Test Aircraft. Although coupling the terms in-flight and simulator may sound counterintuitive, this is one of the few aircraft in the world that can be configured to simulate being any other airplane in the world. Its impressive simulation capabilities thus make it the ultimate pilot training instrument, as it can be programmed to behave as a massive B-52 heavy bomber or a nimble HAL Tejas light fighter. Making the experimental aircraft even more revolutionary is its recent inclusion in the US Air Force Skyborg program, which seeks to explore possible military applications of sophisticated artificial intelligence systems for autonomous combat air vehicles. Consequently, the X-62 VISTA has been dismantled to incorporate an advanced AI computer system, and it now single-handedly possesses more state-of-the-art aviation technology than some countries' entire air forces. Furthermore, the aircraft is poised to become the world's first combat-capable pilotless aircraft, changing the way air warfare is fought forever. At the beginning of the 1980s, the X-62 VISTA was simply a run-of-the-mill F-16 Fighting Falcon built for the Israeli Air Force. In an effort to support Israel and its military needs, U.S. Air Force aviation researchers partnered with Israeli counterparts to further advance the research into multi-axis thrust vectoring technology. MATV was considered a world-shattering technology in the 1980s, as it would allow the dynamic redirection of thrust by controlling the angle of the engine's nozzle. In flight, the MATV feature would allow unparalleled maneuverability, flying straight while the aircraft is in an almost vertical position, and even flying in reverse for a limited time. An F-16 fighter was chosen to undergo the required modifications and house an MATV system. But Israel eventually lost interest in the project, leaving the Endeavor and the modified F-16 in the hands of the US Air Force. Recognizing the massive potential an F-16 with multi-axis thrust had in a wide array of training scenarios, the U.S. Air Force then granted the experimental aircraft to the U.S. Air Force Test Pilot School. Known as the NF-16D VISTA at the time, the aircraft underwent several additional modifications throughout the years to steadily transform it more and more into the ultimate training simulator. The aircraft was fitted with different sets of landing gears to approximate landing conditions in others more closely. Also, specialized flight control instruments were mounted into the cockpits to offer more comprehensive control options for different simulation scenarios. And most importantly, a simulation computer was eventually fitted into the jet to automatically program all the desired characteristics of a flight simulation. By the late 1990s, the aircraft had become one of the most valuable assets of the U.S. Air Force Test Pilot School and an unprecedented tool in attaining and testing new flight technologies. A spokesman for the U.S. Air Force would state, quote, "It can be configured to fly like almost any aircraft type, enabling it to act as a surrogate for a wide variety of platforms." Calspan, a company tasked with maintenance and engineering for the unique simulator, also commented on its unique capabilities, quote, "Its systems provide an outlet to safely simulate environments not available with any other airframe or system." VISTA had transitioned from a single project experiment into one of the most unique and advanced pieces of aviation technology on the planet, becoming a crucial part of the world-class training that combat pilots receive at the U.S. Air Force Test Pilot School at Edwards Air Force Base in California. Skyborg. In July of 2021, the NF-16D VISTA was officially reassigned to the Skyborg program and renamed the X-62A VISTA. The X defines the aircraft as an experimental weapon and makes it a pioneer in the future development of autonomous aerial technology. The U.S. Air Force is currently spearheading efforts to achieve the world's first autonomous, unmanned combat air fleet. If successful, the U.S. military will write the first chapter in what is set to become the future of aviation and warfare. To achieve such a monumental task, the Office of Strategic Development Planning and Experimentation at the Air Force Research Laboratory is conducting accelerated development on an autonomous unmanned combat air vehicle prototype to be ready as early as 2023. The program, known as Skyborg, has a clear roadmap for the goals it seeks to achieve. Beginning in 2023, the U.S. Air Force plans to incorporate artificial intelligence systems as a support utility for pilots in active combat. The idea is to provide every pilot with an AI co-pilot, even when the aircraft wouldn't be able to fit a conventional human co-pilot. The computer co-pilot would then be capable of executing millions of calculations per second to provide the pilot with the most favorable scenarios before every critical decision. The AI co-pilot would also be able to take over the aircraft during low-risk situations when the pilot cannot take command or in life-or-death emergency scenarios. Like the AI robotic help pilots get in numerous sci-fi stories, this technological development would give US pilots an unprecedented advantage when flying into combat. However, the ambitious plans do not end there. If the AI co-pilots are as successful as the Air Force hopes, the next step would be to deploy totally autonomous air combat vehicles. Stemming from the project's first phase, the second one would take advantage of everything the AI learned by providing support to pilots during the initial period. Theoretically, autonomous combat air vehicles would be able to perform adequately and even surpass human enemy pilots. It is expected that reaching complete autonomy will open the door to an entirely new era of aerial combat. In that case, the use of human pilots will only serve a strategic purpose, and the majority of the load will be carried by AI. If successful, the aircraft would then be part of a program called Missionized Nose Swap, which would incorporate modular airframes. As part of the program, advanced module airplane noses would be fitted into the rest of the hull, depending on the mission parameter. If it's a highly specialized mission requiring human interaction, a nose with a cockpit would be inserted, and in the case of a more straightforward operation, a nose housing an AI supercomputer would be fitted instead. Skyborg officially began operations in 2019, and they have successfully traversed down their roadmap since. The Skyborg program manager recently stated, quote, "We've been given the overall objective to have an early operational capability prototype fielded by the end of calendar year 2023. So this is our first step in determining what the current state of the art is from a technology perspective and from a systems engineering perspective to provide that EOC capability in 2023. A fighter commanded by AI. It is not yet clear what role the NF-16D Vista will take in the Skyborg program. Still, it is essential to note that the aircraft has been used before in unmanned aircraft experiments. Hence, it is safe to assume its systems will be further modified to incorporate the latest Skyborg AI technology to achieve more extraordinary performance while flying by itself. The heavily modified F-16 was part of a set of experimental demonstrations named HAL Tejas and HAL Tejas 2 in 2015 and 2017 respectively, where older unmanned computer technologies were showcased. The Lockheed Martin Corporation, currently responsible for producing F-16 aircraft, successfully conducted the HAL Tejas and HAL Tejas 2 tests. During HAL Tejas, the Vista flew autonomously in formation with another F-16D before breaking off to pass along a predetermined route and then fly back into shape with the other jet. During the HAL Tejas 2 test, Vista autonomously conducted simulated strikes on ground targets to suddenly change course in response to pretend alien warnings. Even though Vista technically operated by itself thanks to AI technology, the aircraft was manned by two pilots in case of system malfunction during both tests. Skyborg is one of several current Air Force research and development programs exploring the inclusion of AI and machine learning technologies into the fields of combat aviation, and the advanced upgrades that the Vista is programmed to undertake could easily be employed in other endeavors. As Chief Vista test pilot William Gray said goodbye to the aircraft's career as a test pilot instruction plane, he noted, quote, "For more than two decades, Vista has been a vital asset for the USAF TPS and the embodiment of our goal to be part of the cutting edge of flight test and aerospace technology. It has given almost 1,000 students and staff members the opportunity to practice testing aircraft with dangerously poor flying qualities and to execute risk reduction flight test programs for advanced technologies." With a brand new name and groundbreaking modifications, the X-62A Vista's future looks more promising than ever. Whether it is to become one of the first fully automated AI-supported combat planes on the planet, or serve in a wide range of experimental operations for the US Air Force, the revolutionary aircraft still has a lot to give, 40 years after its construction. Thank you for watching. What do you think AI technology means for the future of warfare? Let us know in the comments below, and stay tuned for more exciting content. Also, don't forget to subscribe to all our Dark Documentaries channels.